inductee, we will be passing the basket. Our next inductee is an educator, award-winning author, and has held executive positions in numerous French-Canadian historical and research organizations, both here in the United States and in Canada. Fame-Choquette is a professor of history, French studies, and director of the French Institute at Assumption College in Worcester. She has authored numerous books and articles on French-Canadian heritage and history. She received the Prix de Québec from the Quebec government for outstanding contribution to the field of Quebec studies, and the Paul Ziegler Presidential Award for Excellence in Scholarship at Assumption College. Leslie is the author of Frenchmen into Peasants, Modernity and Tradition in Peopling of French Canada. It won the Alfred Pigoy Book Prize from the French Colonial Historical Society. It is also selected as one of the 9 best American authored books on Canada by the International Journal of Canadian Studies and has been translated to French. She is a past president of the American Council of Quebec Studies and also served on the executive board and was its secretary. Leslie served on several editorial boards of scholarly journals, including Francophonie de Midi, French Colonial History, and the Journal of Early American History, The American Colonies. And now the American French Genealogical Society is very pleased to welcome Fame-Choquette into our French Canadian Hall of Fame.
I just had to begin in French. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for this great honor of being named to the AFGS French Canadian Hall of Fame. It's all the more important to me because of the other 3 people who are being honored with me here tonight. Paul Bourget, who has done so much for this great city of Woonsocket. Lucie Leblanc, Acadian genealogist and longtime supporter of the French Institute at Assumption College. And Duke Robillard, who besides being a fantastic world-renowned blues musician, was also the guitar teacher of my younger brother Keith back in the 1970s. Tonight, he had another obligation in Connecticut, but he asked me specifically to extend his best wishes and congratulations to Duke. It's also particularly special for me to receive this recognition here in Woonsocket, because even though I was born a little farther down the Blackstone River in Pawtucket, and now I live a little farther up the river in Worcester, my grandfather Choquette grew up here in Woonsocket in extreme poverty. He went on to do pretty well for himself. I have fond memories of riding as a little girl in his sky blue Cadillac, but I'm sure he never imagined in his wildest dreams that his granddaughter would one day be inaugurated into the French Canadian Hall of Fame. So I'd like to dedicate this evening to his memory and the memory of my father. Here's to you, J. Walter Choquette, Senior and Junior. I am part of the 4th generation of the Choquette family to be born here in the United States. And in keeping with what sociologists call the 3rd generation rule, the idea that ordinarily it takes 3 generations for immigrants to assimilate into American culture, I did not grow up speaking French, but I learned French in school. And for any young people who are in the audience tonight, I cannot emphasize enough how much richer my life is because I am bilingual. To give you a single example, just yesterday, I had the amazing honor of working as the interpreter for two French sports legends. Bernard Hinault, five-time winner of the greatest bike race of them all, the Tour de France, and Serge Baudin, a French national bicycling champion. They were both in Worcester for a charity ride to raise money for Souffle d'Espoir, a charity founded by Hinault to support research to cure cancer. Alors, merci encore une fois, et vive le français.